From Studio 3C in Rockefeller Center, this is News 4 New York.
Restoring the health of the Hudson. When we come back, we talk with the grandson of Jacques Cousteau about a project to repopulate the river with shellfish. Welcome back. Well, his grandfather, Jacques Cousteau, is the most famous sea explorer of our time. Now, Fabien Cousteau is now walking in his footsteps, spreading his passion about our oceans and waterways. Now, one of his initiatives is teaching New Yorkers how to replant oysters that have been nearly wiped out of the Hudson River. And Fabien Cousteau joins us now to tell us more about plant a fish. I've heard about planting a tree. We know about that program.
That's right.
What are you doing in the Hudson River?
Well, plant a fish is exactly that. If you've heard planting a tree, why does restoration stop at the waterline? Mm-hmm. So we bring people like you, Tracy,
okay,
or other high schoolers out there to start restoring some of the oyster reefs that used to be here. It was quite literally the financial foundation of New York City, the oyster trade in the Hudson River and beyond. Unfortunately, it was so good that there are very few oysters left.
A little too good.
A little too good.
So how are you working on it now? When did you start this up? And how many oysters do we need to get back into the Hudson to get things up and running again?
Well, not to be scary, but we used to have over 350 square miles of oyster reef, or over 9 billion oysters
in the Hudson.
That's it. We're not quite aiming for that, but anything is better than nothing. Last year, the New York Harbor School was able to plant over a million, and so we hope to continue that for the next few years, along with a dozen or so other entities that are also doing their part.
Now, I imagine you have to kind of convince people that this is a big deal. If this is not achieved, what can we suffer? What can our environment kind of suffer as a result?
It's very simple. A healthy oceans is a healthy people. Without a healthy oceans, there's no such thing as healthy people. It's the circulatory system that makes all life possible on this planet.
And what does it take to plant an oyster? You have to excuse my ignorance. I told you, I admit it, I can't even swim, so.
You don't even need to swim, actually. Most of the activities are land-based. We have other programs as well if you'd like to go on an adventure, say, for example, in El Salvador, where we can have you release baby sea turtles.
Now, you were talking about that earlier. You have a very successful program with sea turtles. Why are you focusing on them, and what do you kind of marvel about? We're looking at the pictures of you down below.
He's actually restoring coral reefs. Mm-hmm. But sea turtles and coral reefs have a kinship. Mm-hmm. And sea turtles are the gardeners of the ocean. Why sea turtles? Well, sea turtles chose us. They live, or they nest, in places like El Salvador, and therefore they're a target of opportunity. Mm-hmm. They're easy to get people involved with, and we also get a chance to get support from local and national companies such as Rainbow Light.
And what has surprised you most about this particular program so far with the sea turtles?
The surprise was how quickly we turned the tide from a bad story.
No pun intended, right?
Exactly.
Right? Turn the tide, I get it.
The fishermen who were originally the culprits are now the solution.
Mm-hmm.
And they went from zero sea turtles in the ocean every year to now they've released over 230,000 just last year through a program.
That's amazing. Well, Fabien, finally tell us how people can become involved here in New York City with the Plant a Fish program. What do they need to do to sign up?
Go online, reach out to us, plantafish.org.
That's easy to remember.
Right?
Plantafish.org.
You can go on Twitter. We have a Twitter handle. We have a Facebook page, all the usual stuff. You can see what we're up to. If you have questions, just ask us.
We will.
If you want to join in, give us a shout.
I'll see you down there.
Absolutely.
Fabien Cousteau, thank you so much for joining us.
Tracy.